In this video, we're going to look at what's new with the Maps app with macOS Sequoia. Basically, we have a new library where we can find all of our guides, our custom routes, which is also new. We can search for hiking trails, and we have a new Search Here button. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Maps app with macOS Sequoia. Let's go over to my Mac. So I'm looking at my Maps app here, and basically this is divided into two. So we have this line here, and over to the right is our map where we can zoom in and out. This is also where I can go and change the view up here. Nothing new there, but when we go over to the left in the sidebar here, this is where we're going to find some new features. The first one being we have a new library. So when I go over here to the top, you're going to see it says library here. So what is this library? Well, this library is where we can find all of our different places that we've saved. It's also where we can find our guides that we've saved. Guides have been in the Maps app for several years, but now we can easily find all of them that we saved in here in our library. And then we can also find our routes that we've created. We can create routes. If you're a walker or a hiker or anything like that, maybe you like to ride bikes, you want to create your own route. What we can do now is create our own route. It'll tell us how far it is, it'll keep us on public roads or public trails, and we can even see the elevation. More on that in a little bit. So this is the big new feature, this library here. Now below the library, we still have all of our different recent locations that we've searched for, things like that, and I can easily search the map here. Let's take a closer look at this library. So to do that, what I do is I just tap on this text here, and when I do, it opens up the library. So from here, I'm able to see which locations I've pinned. I can also see the different places that I've saved. I can see the different guides that I've saved. And then I can also see the different routes that I've created. And then below that, I can see what has been recently added. So when I click on pinned here, here are all the routes that I've pinned. And when we go over to the left here in the sidebar, these are my pinned routes. So you can see that Professor Pizza is pinned, which means that it shows up over here. If I go and remove that pin, let's just go ahead and click on this eye here to remove it. Click on it and unpin it. Now you're going to see that it is no longer over here. I want to add it back in. What I do is I just go back over to where I can find it. We're going to go with Pizzeria Duo. So I just click on it, and I want to add that as a pin. I click on the plus, and now it is in my library as a place, but it is still not pinned. So we can see we have a new place here, but it is still not pinned. I want to pin it. So now what I do is I go over here to these three dots, and then I can go and pin it. And when I pin it, what it's going to do is it's going to show up over here. In addition to that, we can also create notes. So you're going to see that when I look at a location, I have add a note. Only I'm going to be able to see this note, and it will show up on my other devices as long as I use an iOS 18 or iPadOS 18 or greater. So let's go ahead and add a note. I do love their pizza over there. So I just type in here, great pizza. Tap on done, and now that note is in there. So where can I find this note? Well, when you pull up a cart, so I'm looking at Pizzeria Due here, you're going to see that it has my note right there. And again, only I'm going to be able to see this note. This is not a public note. It's just a note for me. If I want to edit it, I can click on it, and then I can go and edit it. If I want to delete it, I can also just go ahead and delete it. So we can easily add notes to our different locations, and then they'll show up under that location. To close this, we just go and click on the X and it'll close that. Let's take a look at places. Places are not pinned, which means they will not show up in this area here. But we can easily find them just by looking at all of our different locations here. And you're going to see that if it is pinned, it does have a pin there. So locations are basically located under places here. But if it is pinned, what it'll do is it'll show up over here. So that's the difference between pinned and places. Now, in addition to that, let's go ahead and click on this X here. We also have our guides. So when I click on this, these are all the guides that I've saved. To create my own guide, I just click on the plus here and it'll ask me to name it, and then I can go and put in locations there. For my own custom guide, will not be public again. Or if I want to search for a guide, I go over here to search, and let's just go with Chicago. And then you're going to see guides. And when I select this, I'm able to see all of the different guides in Chicago. So I just swipe up here, and there are the guides. I click on any one of them, and I can go and save that guide and view it at a later date. It's going to be located under my library. And then the last thing with our library is we also have routes. With routes, what we're able to do is create our own route. Like I said earlier, if you're a runner, a biker, or a walker, anything like that, what you can do is you can create your own route. So what I'm going to do is go and create a new route. So I'm going to click on routes here, and what we're going to do is we're going to create a new route. So I click on it, and now what I need to do is I just need to click where I want to start. So we're going to swim across the ocean here, or the ocean. We're going to swim across Lake Michigan here. Some people do think that it is an ocean. It's 50, 60 miles wide at some points, if not wider. But anyway, swim across Lake Michigan here. And we're going to go into Holland. And we're going to go up to a park here. It's called Tunnel Park. So I just keep zooming in here. And we have Tunnel Park. I want to start at Tunnel Park here. So what I do is I just click in here. I'm going to zoom in a little bit further here. We're going to click right down here to start. This is the parking lot. So I click on it, and that's our starting point. So now we can see it says start. So now what do you do? Well, basically, you just have to click where you want to go. And what it'll do is it'll follow the paths. So you're going to see what it'll do is it'll just kind of follow the road when I click on something. So I'm going to just go down here towards the bottom, and you're going to see that it'll just kind of follow this road here. So it does stick within paths. So I'm going to click down here, and when I do, you can see it just followed that route. Let's go ahead and just keep going down here. We're going to go all the way down here. It's a nice walk. They have a nice bike path there. So I just click here, and you're going to see that it's going to follow this whole route here. So I click there, and now we can see it followed that route. Let's go ahead and click up here. We're going to go over here. So I'm making a nice loop. It's going to go straight up that road. And now I want to be done with this. So I want to go back. So I have a few different options. When I go over to my starting point here, when I click on it, what I'm able to do is reverse the route. I can make it an out and back. I can also close the loop, which is what we're going to do. And then we also have remove point. So I'm going to close this loop. So it's just going to be a loop. I select it. And now it's finding that right route. So now we have my nice route there. And we can see that it is 3 miles. I can also see the elevation. It's relatively flat here in Holland, so not too much of an elevation, but if you're in a hilly area, you're going to actually be able to see that elevation. And then what I need to do next is save it. So when I save this, it's going to save it to that library. So I save it. I can name it. We're just going to go with Tunnel Park. And I click on Done. And now we have that saved in my library. So let's go and find it. I'm just going to close this here. And we're going to close this and close everything else. So I want to find that route. So I go over here to routes. And when I click on routes, you're going to see that I have Tunnel Park. I want to walk it. I just click on it and I can go and get directions for it. And the nice thing about this is not that I'm going to walk it with my MacBook here, but this does sync across all your different devices. So now you're going to find this route on your iPhone. So the Mac, what you can use is the Mac to create the route. Makes it a little bit easier. You can do this also with iOS 18 on the iPhone. But of course, on a Mac, it's going to be a little bit easier. And then once you save it, as long as you use an iCloud, this will sync over to your iPhone and your iPad in the Maps app. And on the iPhone and iPad, you're able to download the map. So then if you're in an area that has spotty cell connection, you can still download that map. So that's how we create routes. It just kind of follows public paths, hiking trails, things like that. And all you have to do is just click. And then from there, you can see how long it is, the elevation, and then you can go and save it. And once you save it, it's in your library. So that is how we now create routes. Another new feature we have is we can also search for hiking trails. So I'm going to close this. And we're going to close this. To search for a hiking trail, what we do is we just go over to our search here and we type in hiking trails. And then you're going to see search nearby. So what this is going to do is this is going to search for hiking trails that are nearby me. So let's go ahead and click on this. And now it is searching for hiking trails. And we can see all the different hiking trails here. So there are 5 hiking trails there. If I click on this, I can actually see those different hiking trails, all part of Sogdook State Park. And if I click on this one here, I can see that they are biking trails. And if I were to click on this, I can view more information about it, including creating a custom route. I can see photos. I can get a rating of it. And I can add my own photos. On top of that, I can see the location as well as report an issue. And if there's a phone number, I'd be able to see the phone number there. If I want to pin this, I can also pin this. And of course, we can also add a note. So I just go up to the More button here, or the ellipsis, 3 dots, click on it, and I can go and add a note. And then that note will show up in this area here. So that's how we can easily search for hiking trails. Another new feature, speaking of search, is we have search here. A problem that we had with the Maps app in the past is when you search for something and you move the map, sometimes the landmarks or the locations wouldn't be updated. Let's see what I mean. So when I go over to the left here, you're going to see that I have pizza. So I'm going to search for pizza, and we're going to search nearby. So when I click on this, it's going to search for pizza places nearby. Now what it did is it just took me over to Detroit. For some odd reason, it thinks that I'm in Detroit here. So what I need to do is I need to move my map. I'm going to zoom out and move the map. And when I do that, so I zoom out here a little bit, and I'm going to move it. Generally, what it's supposed to do is it's supposed to update the pizza joints as I move the map. But if you do it quite a bit here, so I'm going to zoom out here and we're going to go zip across the state. Let's zoom out here a little bit further. And we go over to Holland here. So I'm looking at Holland and now I'm going to zoom in. In some cases, what it would do is it wouldn't update the locations, the pizza locations. Now you're going to see that it's doing a pretty good job here, but let's just say it didn't. Well, what we have now is a new button down here called Search Here. So if it's not updating, what you're able to do is click on Search Here, and then it's going to search that location or where your map is located. So this fixes a little bit of a problem when you're zooming around a map and the locations are not being updated. It should update on its own. As you saw in my case here, it did update on its own. But if it doesn't, what you can do is you can click on that Search Here, and then it'll update it. All of these features are also available on the iPhone with iOS 18 or greater and the iPad with iPadOS 18 or greater. So that is what's new with the Maps app with macOS Sequoia. Basically, what we have is we have a new library where we can find all of our different pins, our places, as well as guides and routes that we've created. We have new hiking trails that we can search for. And we have search here. So when we move around the map and we're searching for something and it's not updating those locations that you're searching for, you can force the Maps app to update its location. So that's what's new with the Maps app on the Mac with macOS Sequoia. Now, if you found this video helpful, you could like the video, you could share it with your friends and family, you could subscribe to my channel. All that helps. But in addition to that, what you may want to do is check out my site, danstutorials.com. I have more videos on my site than I do on YouTube. In addition to that, if you want to help support my efforts, the site is a member-based site. You can view all the videos on there, but you're going to see the ads just like you do with YouTube. But when you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads. You have access to an Apple Genius, an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. I shouldn't say you have access to an Apple Genius. You have access to an AI assistant that is modeled after an Apple Genius. And then you also get access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. And probably most important, you are also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out Dan's tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.